They teach us how and when to find steel in the heart when life makes demands on us. They defy the law of nature by taking the mantle of motherhood and solely carrying a burden that was meant for two hearts. They are our heroes who trudged on when a helpmate was not there. Rewriting the law of nature, they become a bosom of love, hope, and security to their children. Some fathers thrived and strived where mothers failed. They are worthy of our celebration. Some people need to learn from them. On this season of Supermom, we shall be celebrating fathers that gave their children a new lease of life against all odds. If you have such a father, log on to www.supermom.ng or call 081-452-23133. And you can win for him a brand new car, 1 million naira and 500,000 naira. Supermom Season 5. My Dad, My Supermom. Coming soon.
This program is sponsored by Safeguard.
Double protection against germ.
RRB.
All-round protection.
Hunger.
Mama's Helping Hand.
We asked Nigerians to share the stories of their mothers. The sacrifices they made for them. The journey of pain, love, devotion, and struggles made by our mothers to make us who we are today. They shared their stories with us. Thousands of entries, hundreds of interviews, and documentary across the country. 20 unique stories have been selected for us to learn from, appreciate, and celebrate. The sacrifices and devotion are real. Real people, real stories, real experiences. The emotional true life experiences being shared, narrated, and dramatized are simply captivating. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the most touching stories of our mothers. The Supermom Reality TV Show Celebrity Edition starts now.
You're welcome to the most passionate reality show on TV. Today's episode, as always, it's going to be fascinating as we commend yet another two valiant mothers who suffered and struggled to clear a genuine path for their children to pass through. The gift of birthright with which they fostered their children has continued to be a significant motivation for these children to shape their lives. Scales. Scales, a songwriter, rap artist, and performer, this talented young man has wooed many audiences around Nigeria with his unique rap style and charm on stage. From the Zane True Search Talent Hunt competition in 2008 to the Sound City Blast concert in 2009, where he astonished the crowd with a rap a cappella, he has gone to record well over 20 songs and has collaborated with some of the finest music acts like LD, Jeremiah Giang, Banky W, and more. Now signed to Empire Mate Entertainment, two of his singles are currently rocking the airwaves as well as several of his collaborations.
Yes, y'all. I go by the name S to the K-A-L-E-S Skills, and I'm a hip-hop artist signed to Banky W's EME. My real names are John Raoul Njeng. I'm from Edo State. I was born and raised in Kaduna State.
My name is Martina Sani. I'm from Edo State, indigenous of Kaduna. I'm 43 years old, and I'm a teacher with Kaduna Basic Education.
The reasons why I think she's the best mom in the whole world right now to me, and like she's the most beautiful person in the whole world to me, is because my father actually left us when I was like 8 years old, and of course it was like a funny transition for me from being rich to coming to the streets and starting afresh, not having a home, sleeping on mats, sleeping on sand sometimes. Sometimes my mother even do laborer work, And sometimes she hides it from me because she knows, like, it hurts me. Because even though I was 8 years old, I was still smart. I knew what was wrong and what wasn't wrong and everything. So sometimes she's to hide it from me. She's to earn like 500 naira. And at the end of the day, 500 naira, all she'll do is cook food for me to eat. Sometimes she'll go and borrow money from her friends to pay my school fees, to buy me the best Christmas clothes, buy me best Easter clothes. She just always gives me whatever I need. She put me in the best school in Kaduna, which was St. Michael's Anglican Diocesan College. I went to the best primary school, best secondary school. She sent me to university. She gives me allowance. I don't know how she does it.
I thank God for today because since he was 7 years old, the father left us, traveled, telling me he's coming just in 3 months' time. And up to now that I'm speaking, I've not yet seen him.
My father sold everything we had, like every asset we had, our house, everything. He didn't even tell us. He just came and told us to get out of the house. And so he told us he was traveling. He traveled up till now. We've not heard anything from him. But I just feel no matter what, you have your child, so you shouldn't have left your child. And so me and my mother had to move to the streets. We had to, because at that time, my mother had to, like, had issues with her family because of my father, actually. And they actually told her not to, because they had me out of wedlock. So they actually told her not to keep me. And she went out of her way to keep me. And she still loved my father regardless and everything. And he treated her that way. So we moved to the streets and we had to struggle together. But I wasn't really feeling the struggle because my mother was always taking care of me. Probably the only thing was I was just being embarrassed because a lot of people used to know me as a rich kid per se, but I was too young to even notice that.
And we really suffered. And I, as a mother, I cannot let my child. So I tried all my best to see him through his education. I did different job. I sell kose, I sell sugar cane. I work in people's house.
She used to do terrible things. I see them as terrible things because she used to wash clothes for some of my friends' parents. That was funny to me because I felt like it was embarrassing to me.
Mrs. Martina Sani was unable to pay her house rent, which was long overdue.
So I was doing, because I was frying my kose at the garage there, Zaria garage. So when we closed, we don't know where to go because the landlord was disturbing us to pay for the house rent. So, and I had no money. So we now move to the garage. I will sell my kose later in the night, maybe around 12 when we finish. We enter inside there because there's one opening there. We put cartons there, we sleep. Early in the morning before 5, I've dressed him up, come back to where I do my kose. We sleep in, that is the Kaduna, that is Zaria Road. We sleep in the car because when he left us, there was no money to pay for house rent. So even in we slept in the garage up to a week before we now got an assistant, we got a house. So I did many jobs. We really suffered. But all I know, I wanted to see his education because he's a man. I wanted the best for him.
Mrs. Sani made a living by washing plates in a restaurant. It was from these proceeds she sent her son to school when the day was over. And she would sleep in the restaurant with her son since she had not acquired a place of her own. When she had saved enough money, she started selling bread in a shop she acquired, but still slept in her shop at night with her son.
She got a shop in somewhere they call Maraba, in Maraban Jos in Kaduna State. She was selling bread, and then we used to stay in the same shop. We used to live in the same shop. I go to school in the same shop. I used to school in NTI. We thank God because even before my father left, he actually paid like upfront of my school fees because that's how rich we were. He paid like from like primary one, he has paid everything again. All I need, he has sorted it out already. So I was still going to school. My mother was still buying me uniforms and everything. I need textbooks and everything I need for school. And then, finally she got a job, teaching job. We had to like move into town because Maraban just kind of like out of Kaduna town, so we had to move into town to the school was in Kabbalah, so she was a teacher there for like 3-4 years. Then they transferred her to Independence Way, so we had to move to we had to stay in police college, and in police college we stay in the kitchen. Yeah, we stay in the kitchen. It's just a kitchen that they turned into a room apartment. And so I was still going to school regardless then, but I wasn't telling my friends where I was staying. I was always telling them, oh, I was staying in one flat, blah blah blah. Even girls, I was always lying to them, but they never knew where I used to just escape, and I used to just come out from nowhere and go to school still looking good and everything, not looking like I'm suffering.
She was not making enough money from the sales of bread, so she decided to go from house to house asking if there was anything she could do. Together with the proceeds from the bread sales, she took care of herself and, most importantly, her son.
I now met a man of God. He's called Bishop Fred Addo and his wife. They now help us physically, spiritually, even financially. So they now backed us. But I was there struggling, doing everything. They continue encouraging me that I can make it. That I can make it. I should ride on with him. Without him, I can make it. I will go to my job. Weekends, I go out to do petty sales or to do jobs in people's house just to see his education.
She borrows loans from school and her friends to pay for my, when I moved into secondary school. She was always getting loans from school, so she was always in debt. Like, sometimes she doesn't see her salary at all, because she always pays debt when she gets her salary, or sometimes she sacrifices for me. When excursions too, she sacrifices her salary because it was small. I think that time they were paying her like, she doesn't tell me anything. I just find out because I go out on my, I must find out what's going on, because she doesn't want me to know that, oh, she's going through this, she's going through that. Sometimes I come back, meet her, she's crying because she's sick, but she doesn't have money to go and buy drugs and all that. There was even a night I was really scared that she was going to die because she was throwing up blood.
I was teaching. When I come back from my job, I start my business 3 o'clock, the Kose business. I started 3 o'clock. I close any time I want in the at night. So I did that one for some time and stopped. When the business is no more moving again, I will switch again to another one just to survive. Number one, his education was just what I was after. So that was why I was doing all this. And why I left the job then, because the salary, I was collecting 365 naira then. So I saw it was not okay. I was even schooling then, but because of his own, I have to leave my own school so that he can continue his own school.
The Supermom Reality TV Show.
Girl, I know you love me. Girl, I know you do. Stop on the front, you know they use me, catch you cruise.
Okay, so I got one of my friend's house. His name is Daniel Addo, and I saw my mom cleaning up their house and washing things and just doing that day. I felt really bad. I felt bad because those kids, okay, they were spoiled. They were cool because they're my friends, you understand? But they were also spoiled. So I was imagining, oh, what they would be saying. It's not like they were saying or doing anything wrong, but my imagination was just killing me. I was like, my conscience was just messing with me. I was feeling bad. Sometimes I used to go and tell my mother, as if we have another option. I used to go and tell my mom, don't do this, as if there's another option. You know? But I always saw myself as somebody that was going to be great in life, even though I'm still on my way. I used to always imagine me doing this. I tell my mom I'm going to own this, I'm going to own that. And my mom doesn't used to doubt me. She'd be like, yeah, of course, she's my mom. So she'd be like, yeah, just keep working. Just keep, that one day you change our story for us. There's this girl I used to have a crush on. Then finally we started dating. I think we started dating, yeah. She was in my church. We started dating and I'm like, she's too fine. I'm looking for the girl up till now. Like, I used to go to, her name is Selima Ali. I'm sure my mother doesn't know much about the girl. It's just low-key me. I knows it. So one day, I just went to the girl's house and I bumped into my mother. My mother was the one braiding. They told me that, oh, they're making their hair, blah, blah, blah. Then I just went in. It was my mom that was braiding their hair. And then I was surprised, but I was not like I was surprised. I was ashamed, actually. I was ashamed because they were like, oh, do you mind this? Do you know how the girls complain, blah, blah, blah. And it was my mother and there was nothing I could do. So I just went there. I just messed around with everybody. I had to stay there till my mother finished. And now they found out it was my mom, because they didn't really know it was my mom all this while. They didn't know it was my mom. So they found out it was my mom. And then, okay, basically they had to become sweet to my mom. because of that, because of the fact that you found. So whenever she does anything wrong, they have to say, oh ma, you have to do this, but it was embarrassing to me.
She did not stop there. She worked on a construction site to give a lease of life to her son.
It was during that time, so the bricklayer, if I see where they say they are doing bricklayer, I will go there. I will beg, they will give me a chance to do it. When they mix the sand, we will be packing it for them to build. I did that for not too long, because when I started, I was enjoying, but later my body was paining me. I have to drop it and look for something else again to do.
He came home late one day because, according to him, he lost track of time while rehearsing. Mrs. Martina beat her son thoroughly, and that served as enough punishment for him.
We're rehearsing late and I lost
time. Shut up! I said, what time is it?
It's 10 p.m.
Mom. And what time is your coffee?
8 p.m.
So what happened?
Mom, but...
Shut your mouth. Now listen, young man. Two captains can never be in a ship. Is that clear? Once it's 8 o'clock, you must be inside this house. Rehearsing my food.
Then, okay, I was in university. She used to send me allowance. I don't know how she used to do it. All these things, she's not like she told me. I found out, like I just found out later on how she was doing it and everything. And she used to sell her wrapper sometimes. She used to borrow money to send me allowance, like anytime I'm broke in school and I call her. And all this while I was still hustling doing my music though. So okay, one day I just finally told her that, you know what, this is what I want to do. I want to do music, blah blah blah. She was like, okay, you know what, go to school because you've come this far already. So just close your eyes, finish it up, get your degree, make sure your grades are good. And you can still be doing music aside, no problem. I don't have a problem with that. That's what she told me. Then, with God's grace, or by God's favor, I won a competition in Jos when I was still schooling in University of Jos. I was studying banking and finance. I was doing diploma actually before I moved to degree. And so I won a competition. It was like 1,000 people and I came out number one. And so later on, I got fed up. I just decided to, since I won the competition and I had a name on TV, I wanted to move down to Lagos. So I told her. My mom said no, she didn't want me to go anywhere because I'm like her only child again, so she didn't want me to go anywhere. So I was a stubborn kid too, so she was like no, I wasn't going. I told her that my friends, that she shouldn't worry, I have where to stay and I'm always going to keep in touch, but and I'm always going to be going to school from Lagos.
Just promise me your education
will be secure. Mom, I'll do just that. Thank you very much, Mom.
Thank you very much, Mom. She also supported me, like, mentally. Everything I needed, actually, basically, she just gave me. Like, when I was going to perform again, she used to buy costumes for me, too, as part of it. Like, that time, because I used to perform in church. I used to be, like, a gospel rapper. So, like, the first time I rapped in church, we were wearing white and black. My mother had to go and sew a white top for me and a black trouser for me. She bought new shoes, brand new shoes for me. And so that's it.
One thing with me, I don't like discouraging person. Immediately he told me he want to do music. I said, okay. Because you can't discourage somebody with what he wants. Since that is what he loves, me too, I love it. And he's a child that I love, that whatever he told me he wants to do, so far if it's not a bad thing, go ahead.
Anything. So that's why I think she's the best mom in the world, because she sacrificed everything for me. She sacrificed her life, her time, her energy, everything, just to make me, bring me this far. And that's why I think she's the best mom in the world, and a great person, and a person with a golden heart. Basically, that's why I think she's the best mom in the world.
The sacrifice I did for him, I gave my life. It's my life I give. Even people that knows, they know that I've given my life to him. And that is why God was behind us and he saw us through. He gave me a perfect child. Understood? God gave me a perfect child. So the sacrifice was, it was my life I've given him. And as many that knows, they know that Tina has given her life to that boy.
the Supermom reality TV show.
The advice I have for mothers, they should encourage their children. The best, both if she's a girl or she's a boy, they should help them. Help them in whatever they want to do. Especially number one, education. If they are not even interested in education, there's a way you draw a child closer, you cancel the child before you know he will develop interest. So parents should always help their children, especially mothers. They should not leave everything for father. Even if they are with their father, because some fathers are decoration. If my father is not ready, the woman should forget about father and do what is good for the children. Because if it's good for that child, na papa get her. If it's bad, na mama get her. So women should stand up for their children.
The Supermom reality TV show.
I want to say a big thank you to you for everything you've done for me, for bringing me this far, for sending me through school, for giving me the knowledge and understanding about life, and for please putting God in me and for teaching me to overcome whatever circumstances I'm in. Thank you very much, and you're the most beautiful woman to me in the world, and I'll do whatever it takes to make you the greatest person in my life or in the world right now. Thank you very much. I'm grateful. God bless you.
They teach us how and when to find steel in the heart when life makes demands on us. They defy the law of nature by taking the mantle of motherhood and solely carrying a burden that was meant for two hearts. They are our heroes who trudged on when a helpmate was not there. Rewriting the law of nature, they become a bosom of love, hope, and security to their children. Some fathers thrived and strived where mothers failed. They are worthy of our celebration. Some people need to learn from them. On this season of Supermom, we shall be celebrating fathers that gave their children a new lease of life against all odds. If you have such a father, log on to www.supermom.ng or call 081-452-23133. And you can win for him a brand new car, 1 million naira and 500,000 naira. Supermom Season 5. My Dad, My Supermom. Coming soon.
This program is sponsored by Safeguard.
Double protection against germ.
RRB.
All-round protection.
Hunger.
Mama's Helping Hand.